Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, my name is Mega Putriana, my register number A1M219011. On this occasion, I will discuss and explain about noun clause and clause of comparison. Okay, let's see what is a noun clause. A noun clause is a dependent clause that takes the place of any noun in the sentence, whether they are subjects, objects, or subject complements. For example, she was saddened by what she had read. Dia sedih dengan apa yang dia baca. In the sentence above, the noun clause what she had read is being used as the object of the preposition by. Okay, setelah mengetahui apa itu noun clause, mari kita lihat beberapa contoh dari noun clause itu sendiri. I know what you want. Aku tahu apa yang kamu inginkan. Di mana what you want di sini berfungsi sebagai noun clause-nya. Contoh kedua, we still don't know how that thief entered your house. Kami masih belum mengetahui bagaimana pencuri itu masuk ke dalam rumahmu. Di mana how that thief entered your house bertindak sebagai noun clause-nya. And the last is, Anderson is wondering why she loves Peter. Anderson sedang bertanya-tanya kenapa dia atau wanita itu mencintai Peter. Di mana why she loves Peter bertindak sebagai noun clause-nya. After knowing the noun clause, we will see what are the functions of the noun clause. There are several functions of the noun clause, namely as a subject, as an object, object of the preposition, and subject complement. Okay, the first is noun clause as a subject. Noun clause can function as subject of sentence. For example, why my pet turtle stares at me all day is beyond me. In the sentence above, the underlined noun clause acts as a single subject of the independent clause. Okay, next. The second is noun clause as object. Noun clause can also function as object of the verb in independent clause. For example, when my dog goes to doggy daycare, I don't know what he does, but he always has the best time. In the sentence above, the noun clause what he does, the noun clause what he does is acting as the direct object of the verb noun. Next, noun clause as object of the preposition. Other times, noun clause can act as the object of the preposition in the independent clause. For example, I like to keep a schedule of when I have upcoming appointments. In the sentence above, the noun clause when I have upcoming appointments is acting as the object of the preposition of. Okay, and the last is noun clause as subject complement. Noun clause can act as subject complements or nouns that follow linking verb. For example, actors can become whomever they want to be on the stage. In the sentence above, the noun clause whomever they want to be is the subject complement of the linking verb become. Okay, next, we will discuss about clause of comparison. What is clause of comparison? Clause of comparison or a comparative clause is a subordinate clause type that follows the comparative form of an adjective or adverb. As the name implies, this English clause that start with as and then serve to express comparisons. There are two basic ways to compare two things, namely by using the correlative conjunction as or than. The first is correlative conjunction as. As is followed by an adjective or adverb and a phrase or clause when comparing the same or similar things. For example, the room is as small as my room at home. The room is as small as my room at home. Kamar ini sekecil dengan kamar saya di rumah. Kamar ini sekecil kamar saya di rumah. Kita membandingkan dua kamar, kamar satu dan kamar saya. Jadi bisa kita simpulkan bahwa kamar satu dan kamar saya ini ukurannya sama. Contoh kedua, Gary is as brilliant as his sister. The correlative conjunction than is used at the beginning of the comparative clause after the comparative adjective or adverb. For example, I find running harder than swimming. Contoh ini merupakan bentuk comparative clause diikuti oleh comparative adverb, di mana hard di sini berfungsi sebagai adverbnya. Contoh kedua, she sings better than Clara does. Bentuk ini merupakan bentuk comparative clause diikuti oleh comparative adjective, di mana better di sini berfungsi sebagai adjektifnya. The new machine works more efficiently than the old one. Ini bentuk dari comparative clause diikuti oleh comparative adverb. Okay, I think enough from me. Thank you and see you next time.